Hey, we'll call the Safety and Public Properties meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Here.
Mr. Russo?
Here.
Mr. Zellwin?
Here.
Okay, seeing how this is a Safety and Public Properties meeting, and this is September 11th, I'd just like to have a moment of silence to recognize the people that we lost on 9/11. May we never forget.
Amen.
Brings us to the approval of the minutes of August 13th, 2019.
I move that we approve the minutes of August 13th, 2019.
Second?
Second.
We have a motion, a second. Roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, brings us to reports. We have one report under jail reports. Mr. McGee, anything that you'd like to bring to the committee's attention?
Nothing, just the usual jail report.
Okay, any questions from the committee?
None from me.
Okay, great, thank you. Okay, brings us to police and fire. Item number two, we had a memo from Police Chief Filing concerning the jail service contract with amendment with University Heights. Mr. McGee?
This is a amendment to a previous agreement that we had that extends the contract with University Heights for additional 2 years. We've made some slight changes to the terms that financially benefit City of Solon.
Questions? I'll entertain a motion.
I'd like to request legislation be prepared authorizing the mayor and the police chief enter into an amendment to our jail service contract with University Heights under emergency.
Second.
Motion, a second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, item number three, a memo from Police Chief Filing concerning the jail service contract amendment with Shaker Heights. And Sergeant McGee, anything that...
Just this is an additional jail service contract amendment with Shaker Heights, extending the contract for an additional 2 years at the same terms.
Question on this contract. Okay, I'll entertain a motion.
I make a motion for legislation to be prepared authorizing the mayor and the police chief to enter into the amendment of the jail services contract with Shaker Heights. And it doesn't look like this needs to be under emergency.
Right, yeah, because we've got a January 1st effective date. Okay, we have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Motion, a second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
It brings us to item number four, a memo from Police Chief Filing concerning the jail food service contract and the RFP results. Sergeant McGee?
Council granted permission for us to go out and request proposals for food service. We did receive two responsive bids and judged Airmark to be the most responsive of those bids. They're also our current vendor, so we are requesting to have approval to enter into a contract with them.
Any questions from the committee?
Just a quick question. I see that one of the vendors that submitted a bid was Jim Alessi's. Have they done this kind of service before?
They actually did. So Jim Alessi's provided food service for the City of Solon Jail for approximately 2.5 years.
Okay. I'm just curious. Thank you.
You're welcome.
No further questions. I'll entertain a motion.
I'd like a legislation be prepared authorizing the mayor and the finance director to accept the proposal of Airmark Correctional Services to enter into a multi-year contract with the city jail.
Motion. Is there a second?
Second.
We have a motion, a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, brings us to traffic enforcement, traffic report. Any questions from the committee concerning the traffic report?
How is the new speed trailer working out?
Obviously much better than the old broken one. So I know that we're still testing it and have it out at a number of different places, and we're evaluating its...
Well, that was really the question, because it's new.
Right.
What kind of evaluation do you go through? Do you have to retest it at a certain point in time?
The biggest issue with those is always looking at the data that's coming in, if we are collecting data or the you know, the visibility as far as where it's placed. Sometimes that can become an issue.
So it does give you stored data that you can download later and evaluate?
Be perfectly honest with you, I'm not 100% familiar with the capacities of the particular device that we just purchased.
I'd be curious if that were the case.
Right.
Probably get that at the next meeting.
Yeah.
So I would just like to make note that selective enforcement was done on Brooklyn Avenue. We had a residents meeting for the construction work in Arbordale. The residents did bring that up as a concern and wanted to have selective enforcement when school came back in session. And again, realizing that street was shut down, the traffic would only move to Brookland, which would keep moving down. So selective enforcement was put on Brookland, and in the 16 hours that were spent in two different locations, there were 3 citations and 7 warnings on that. So I just wanted to make sure that the residents around the high school were aware of that. Jeremy?
No, I've got several resident complaints about some areas for selective enforcement, if I can add those to the list. So the first is Flanders, right around Winston in Thornberry. And the second is Ward 6, Spice Bush and Nightshade. So early in the morning there, right around the high school hours, I was at my brother-in-law's who live over there, and his neighbors were saying that a bunch of high school kids tend to run that stop sign right there and speed down the street right in that area. So if you can check that out as well in the mornings on
school weekend. Morning hours for both locations?
Just for Spice Bush and Nightshade. The other one, the residents are complaining just in general about usually teenagers, again, speeding down the streets there.
Okay, we'll add it to the list.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Okay, we will move to Public Works. We have a memo from Mr. Dursick concerning the cooperative agreement 2019 to 2020 deer management program. Mr. Dursick?
Yes, this is the similar agreement that we've been joining forces with the United States Department of Agriculture to take care of our deer management in the city of Solon. This agreement is a continuation of the service that's been provided to the city of Solon as part of our deer management plan. We would like to continue to see that this management of deer population continue because of fewer car crashes and car accidents with relationships to deer. Lowering the cost of property damage, incidents, and injury for the motoring public of Solon. I'm requesting that the competitive bid process be waived, citing that the filing criteria set by Ohio supplement contracts with non-qualified nonprofit agencies and contracts with state departments, political subdivisions, or regional planning commission may be authorized without bidding or advertising. This cooperative agreement, we would like it to begin on October 1st, expire July 31st, in the amount of $53,366. And I would request this be done under emergency so we can start it as of October 1st.
Okay. Any questions from the committee?
Not for me.
Entertain a motion.
I move that legislation be prepared, authorizing the city to waive the competitive bidding arrangement and select the United States Department of Agriculture, Animal, and Plant Health Inspection Services for the deer management program in the amount of $53,366 under emergency.
Second.
We have a motion, a second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, item number 7, we have a memo from Mr. Bandera concerning the salt storage facility, lean-to addition and re-roofing contract. Mr. Bandera?
Thank you. This project is kind of an extension from the salt barn addition that was done in 2018. Because of that addition that was put on the salt barn, a couple of the lean-tos on the sides of the salt barn had to be removed to just allow for the addition project to take place. So this project is to put those lean-tos back up. The service department uses those for seasonal equipment. Mainly our leaf loaders get stored underneath there. So currently, as of last winter, after the program's over, those pieces of equipment have to just be stored outside. We don't have room down there for it. So we went out to bid for this project on August 16th. One sealed bid was received and opened for this project, contract number 2019.25. There was an engineer's estimate set for this project of $71,000, and the apparent low bidder was Park Lane Construction, and they submitted a bid of $66,830. In about 1980, Park Lane Construction put up the original salt barn for the service department. So they were the winning bidder back in 1980. They did a beautiful job with that barn for the size of the city at the time, but our lane miles and the size of the city has nearly doubled, so that's why we kind of expanded that barn. But when the expansion project went out to bid, Park Lane also was the winning bidder of that. So they're really familiar with this particular structure and the plans associated with how to build the lean-tos off of them and the structure. So based upon their past experience working with the city and their vast knowledge of this particular project, the service department's requesting that legislation be prepared to award the salt storage facility and lean-to addition remodeling project to Park Lane Construction in the amount of $66,830. And if the committee concurs with this, we'd like that legislation to be passed under emergency. We'd like to get the project done before the weather turns this year so that we could have that storage for the equipment. And I'd also like to add the other part of this project was to get rid of the existing asphalt roofs left on part of the lean-tos that didn't have to be removed in 2018, and we're going to put metal decking on those roofs so that'll last for 50 to 60 years. So then everything will be consistent on this building with metal decking. And I can answer any questions the committee might have.
Very good.
Any questions from the committee? Okay, seeing that there are none, entertain a motion.
I would request legislation be prepared to award the salt storage lean-to addition and re-roofing project contract number 2019-25 to Park Lane Construction in the amount of $66,830 under emergency.
Second?
Second.
A motion, a second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, brings us to engineering. Item number 8, Swage Lock traffic study. I've got down here no new material.
The study's been completed. Since the time it was originally completed, Swage Lock actually changed the logistics of their internal movements on their site, so I had to ask GPD to reevaluate the study based on those changes. That has been resubmitted to our office. I haven't had a chance to review it yet, but if you would like us to present the study to the committee, we can do that probably at next month's meeting.
Great. Any questions?
Nope.
No, that's good to know. Welcome
right
back.
Brings us to item number 9, status update report for August. Mr. Bush, and welcome back,
couple,
by the way.
Just a couple of things. One is the Harper Road feasibility study, ODOT. GPD has finished their initial feasibility study, submitted it to ODOT. ODOT provided some comments back to us, which GPD did respond back to those comments. And the next step for the city would be to have a public hearing by which we would present some of our findings and preferred alternatives, just to have public input before we would move forward with the actual interchange modification study. So I'll work with GPD to schedule that here at City Hall at some time.
Okay.
Other than that, the community center exterior masonry project is under construction, and we anticipate that to be done here before winter. If there's any other projects that the city has any questions about, I can address those now.
Just had a question about is that an ammonia tank at Nestle that they're replacing?
They are putting in what they call a tank farm to service the processes they do there. I'm not sure if it's just ammonia or if it's other different ones. I'm really not sure to the specifics of all of the tanks that they're utilizing or need there.
Well, the biggest concern is the ammonia, because when they've had spills in the past, that's been problematic. I was just curious if that's a project that we're overseeing, or is it they're in control of the subcontractor?
We have had several meetings with all of our departments involved. I know the fire department's been at all of those meetings as well, so they're aware of all the proposed changes that are going on there.
Okay. Any further questions? Jeremy?
So
John, I know that there's been, and Bill, lots of, especially today, questions and comments regarding 91 and the lane code closures, and if work's getting done, if you could just address, you know, I think one of the things that the city did is they consciously did the night, most of the work at night, so people are complaining about not seeing people there and why are there lane closures. If you could just talk about how long some of these lane closures may last and when we could start seeing some asphalt going back down on the ground.
The process that's going on currently is base repairs to the existing concrete base on 91, and I think the area you're speaking to is the section between on Somme, between the railroad bridge and US 422.
Yes.
The contractor milled off all of the existing asphalt, and now we're currently doing some base repairs to the existing concrete base. That is proposed to take about 3 weeks, weather depending, and then once those repairs are completed, the asphalt work will, or the asphalt base course will go down. Some of the lane closures need to, and some of the work needs to coincide during the day and at night, because the, even if the contractor can prepare the slots for the repair, the concrete repairs at night and pour them at night, they would still have to cure out during the day. So that's why the lanes would have to stay closed, whether the work was done at night or during the day.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Any other questions? Okay, brings us to Service Department. Item number 10, Service Department HVAC Systems Upgrade Study. Still no new material? Do we have an idea where we are with that project?
Yeah, I do not have any new material right now, but I could put the committee on notice. Our plans are to write a specification specifically for the first phase of that project, so we have identified some of the areas that are really the main concern, one being the tox alert system, and replacing a couple of the makeup air units so that we can get that system working again, because that's what provides the fresh air to the building when the trucks start up in the morning. So we're just going to try to scale that project back. We will be coming back to the committee, obviously, once we get that spec written and, you know, put it out to bid and hopefully get some good response on that. So
that brings us to the end of our agenda. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion a second. Roll call, please.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Meeting adjourned. Thank you.